Hey, good morning, campers. Today is December 7th, the day known to be an infamy. Well, I'm starting a new picture today. And we're going to do a music review on Iggy Pop. I'm going to start playing him right now and start drawing this character. Not necessarily a huge Iggy Pop fan. I've only heard maybe a few songs of his. I know more about him in his live performances, more than anything. I played way too late in that song, but I thought it was like a 5 minute song that I looked up and realized it was only a 3 minute song. But from what the sound of it, I could see now why Iggy Pop played with like the bands like The Cure on tour. I'm not a big Cure fan either, but like I thought that Iggy Pop would be more raw punk rock. You know, I know he's got some stuff that is. But from what I was listening to this song so far, I was like kind of getting the feelings of kind of like almost like a death rock feel, like something that even Typo Negative would have been good with. Sometimes when I listen to bands, I really like the first thing I do is like, man, I would love to see this band with this band. And like, you know, like I really feel Motorhead, the Ramones, and Amoebics would have been great. Oh, and Venom, any of those bands right there together would have been an epic show. And like, I feel that some bands complement each other by the sounds of they put out, you know, that's not so much the style, but just the recording style of them, you know. Now the reason why I learned that that Iggy Pop had toured or played shows with The Cure is because I was listening to a Henry Rollins interview, and Rollins and Iggy, I guess, like, you know, were having like the who can show each other up on stage, you know, two very impressive like front men, you know. And so I guess Rollins played, and like Iggy like said, good show, and like he felt like, you know, like he had the show beat. And then of course Iggy went on after Rollins before Cure, and like there's all kinds of like flowers, I guess, on stage that he was saying, and Iggy Pop destroyed all the flowers on stage that were for The Cure. It wasn't like a, it was like, you know, something, the stage prop for The Cure, for like the headlining act, and Iggy had destroyed all the flowers. So I wish there was video for me to kind of watch it. There probably is nowadays. You never know, like, you sneeze funny and it's on a video somewhere. But today I'm starting a new video, a new beginning, a new day of an infamy. I decided to, I had other women, you know, ask if I would draw them or something like that. Maybe it's kind of flattering to some, but I decided to walk away from that today and kind of go into something that I don't know, that kind of, as a kid I was a huge fan of this guy, and when I was 5 years old it was about him, Godzilla, Jaws, with a cartoon called G-Force at the time that I was really big into also. But anyways, Iggy Pop, I now I'm curious of actually listening to an album of his. If anyone knows of an album from Iggy Pop to check out, I'd love to check it out. The songs that I'm familiar with is, of course, the ones that Slayer covered. And I'm familiar with, of course, the Train Spotting, I think it was called, the heroin movie. Lust for a Life. I also read something in a book that Jim Morrison was hanging out with Iggy Pop at one point. I don't know if this was the same dude or not, but it'd be nice to know. I'm going to put the song back on for a second. We got it literally like 1 minute left of it. Let's see if there's another. This is another Iggy Pop song. This is Love's Missing. You know, I'm actually It's kind of crazy to think, man, like this day in history that Japan had attacked the Hawaiian Islands. It is something to think that there's that generation of people or have grown up with that tragedy and seen so many other tragedies that this country's gone through. And here we are living in the time of the COVID and Trump era of presidency, and now we got Biden. I don't think Trump's going to be able to stop Biden from taking the presidency, really. And the fear of China. I mean, we have like a kind of a China fear now going on through our country, you know, like can't trust China. I mean, well, we had that fear even in the 90s, believe it or not. You know, they'd send toys and we'd test them and realize that they were packed with all kinds of like lead paint and stuff like that for our kids to play with. And I guess the only thing I can say that I fear about China is they're willing to move at a snail's pace to take over a country. They will have the patience of not even slinging a stone, and they'll accomplish their mission. But I don't think we're going to go to war with China. That'd be nuts. I mean, I think that's what we've learned from our experience of Korea and Vietnam. You know, they got the manpower, the bodies to do it. You know, we don't have that kind of thirst for blood in our society, really. You know, we're willing to risk millions and millions of people for a cause anymore. We don't have that. I think it would take something literally like an attack like Pearl Harbor, maybe. Who knows? But this new series of paintings is going to be called The Days After the Day of Infamy. I figure, why not? Today I got a painting I'm doing that's a giant chaos symbol with a train crash. It's an order for someone. Coming down to the 14-minute mark. Like I said, I'm only going to do 15 minutes a day on these drawings. And gives me a good warm up of the day, really. That's why I do this. Plus, I kind of enjoy doing pen and ink for a little bit instead of all paint. This is more of a challenge than painting, actually. Because, you know, if I mess up on this, man, there's no fixing it. I just got to live with it, you know, until the picture's done. All right, well, we're at the 15-minute mark. Once again, my name is Raymond Cowell. Better music taste than Simon Cowell. I'll give you guys a further look to see who I'm drawing. And I hope you guys have a good day.